Hey everyone, in this video you will learn how to send R and Python execution to SQL Server from your own IDE. This is a great feature because you no longer have to transfer data out of SQL Server to leverage R and Python, and you get to stay working in the IDE you're familiar with. No more waiting on long network transfers over ODBC connections, no more need to extract sample CSV files to take to your client. Write your code where you want it and send the execution to SQL Server where your data lives. While this video will show you an example of Python and Jupyter Notebooks, you can do the same thing with R, and you can use any tool you like RStudio, Visual Studio, VS Code, PyCharm, etc. In order to complete the steps in this video, you will need Machine Learning Services installed on SQL Server. Check out the description below for a link to another video to help you get set up. In order to send Python execution from your client Jupyter Notebook to SQL Server, we need to leverage a Microsoft library called RevoscalePy. You can get RevoscalePy on your client machine by downloading our Python client from the documentation page linked in the video description below. This is an Anaconda distribution with RevoscalePy and many other popular data science open source packages pre-installed. After downloading the installation script, open up PowerShell as an administrator. Execute the script with the InstallFolder command specifying where you want your Python client installed. Be patient while this installation may take a little while. Once installed, navigate to the path you installed in and open Jupyter Notebooks with this command. Let's create a new notebook by clicking New and Python 3. To test if everything is set up, import RevoscalePy in the first cell and execute. If there are no error messages, you are ready to move forward. To copy-paste the code you see in my Jupyter Notebook, check out the video description below. First, we're going to set up SQL with the well-known IRIS dataset. This first cell uses PyODBC to create a database. Modify the connection string for your information and execute. This cell imports the built-in IRIS dataset from the sklearn package. This cell leverages RevoscalePy to insert the data into a new table. Now that your database is set up, let's write a function that we want to remotely execute in SQL Server. Define any function you want to send. In this case, we are going to make a scatter matrix of the IRIS dataset. Specify what you want to return back to your client machine. In this example, I only return the byte stream of the scatter matrix image so I can visualize and explore the results in Jupyter Notebooks. Now using RevoscalePy, I specify a remote compute context with a connection string to my SQL Server. Using argexec, I can chip off the function to be executed in SQL. All of the computation happens there, and only the image byte stream is returned for me to display in my Jupyter Notebook. Now, I know we had to do a few setup steps so that you could follow my code in this tutorial, but once you're set up, check out how easy this really is. All we had to do was import RevoscalePy, create a SQL compute context, and then send the execution of any function seamlessly to SQL Server with argexec. You now know how to send R and Python execution from any IDE to SQL Server. Check out links in the description below to learn more and see how you can also write R and Python directly in your T SQL statements.